Hello everyone, this is Eagle and welcome back in a new series from Steel Division 2. This time I am reviewing all the divisions in the game. Basically, I'm gonna pick a division every time and review it historically and review it review its performance in the game. Currently Eugene has over 80 division. They added over 80 division into the game, and let's see if these divisions are worth playing or they are just bad divisions. Also, let's see how their actual historical representation are. So before we start, let me just explain or highlight one important point here, which is confusing to many of people. And I think there is a big misconception regarding this point. So Eugene refers to these divisions as battle groups, and then when you enter the battle group, then it mentions division here, and some divisions are mentioned as corps, like what you can see here, second guard tank corps. So basically there is a big difference between a corps, divisions and battle group. So a corps is the higher structure of any military structure. You find the corps come first, and then the corps basically consist of 2 to 5 divisions, and then the divisions have some brigades inside it, and then the brigades have some battle groups. So the battle groups are actually less in structure than the division, and the division is less in structure than the corps. And that is where the confusion comes. But since Eugene have made all this confusion in the game, most of the players, including myself, just refer to this as division, so we just ignore the corb and ignore the battle group or whatever. Most of the people just refer to every one of these as a division. Having said that, the second guard corps, which is the division that I'm gonna choose today to play with, is actually corps, which means it had multiple divisions inside it or multiple brigades. But there is an important point here, which is that in World War II, some of the corps in the Soviet Union were actually in the same size of the divisions in the German army, like the Panzer divisions. So that could be one of the reasons why Eugene considered a corp as a division in the game, corps as a division in the game. However, it could be also due to a confusion, I'm not sure. But anyway, I have included some links in the description. You can check them out, which actually explain the difference between the division, the corps, and the battle group. Now let's take our division here, which is the second guard tank corps, which is basically mentioned here that it is one of the historical divisions that fought in Operation Bagration, and it is considered as a sledgehammer to the Soviet Union army. And this this division has lost lots of units during the fight against the Germans, and it was reformed multiple times, and new equipment were added to the division. So it will be a bit hard to make sure that every unit represented in this division is actually were there in the truth, or maybe were not there, because there was lots of guys, and during the course of the war equipment were adding were added to the division due to the loss of the equipment. But it's also worth to mention that this division have never been surrounded like other divisions. It was one of the divisions that lost many equipment, but were never surrounded. They continue fight until the end. So they are supposed to be a spearhead division, which may be why they put this spear here as a logo or a slogan for the division. Let's see the division itself, if it's that good or not. So here is the second guard. Well, let me first say that I have tried this division. I played some couple of games with this division, but I have lost badly using this division, and it's actually not as good as it should be. And I think with Eugene continuing adding more divisions to the game, the old divisions become a bit weaker. So they need to do something to balance the old divisions to make them on the same bar with the new division added. Having said that, when I adjusted the balance income from balanced to Vanguard, I started having a good results, better results, slightly better results against other players. But it was very difficult task to play with this division. This is how I configured my division. So let's see. So on the recon side, I just used one card of light armor, and I usually like to use light armored vehicles. And in a tank division like this, which is supposed to be a spearhead, a fast moving division that can break through enemy, it should have more recon armor unit, but apparently this is not the case here. So anyway, I like to have this kind of unit in my division, especially in a tank division. So that's why I picked this. And I also picked the Radveska, which is a recon unit with bazooka. And this bazooka is the best anti-tank weapon in the game. Basically, it has 250 meter range, which is really good. I didn't add more cards because it's a bit expensive to use the recon in this division. In the infantry card, and I have to say the infantry in this division is the weakest. So I filled all the cards. Some might say, why you didn't use a leader? I added a leader in the artillery tab, but I just didn't want to waste the limited cards here. So that's why I used all the cards, and I adjusted them according to the Vanguard income. So I had more unit in phase A. I had some units in phase A in close combat and also in longer range. Tanks, basically it only has T-34s 85 and this poor T-34 76. So I added one card of these just, you know, in case you need something cheap to counter light tanks or something. And then I just continued adding the T-34s. I added six tanks in phase A because I'm planning to rush and pressure basically my opponent in phase A. It is also said here that this division works in phase A, so that better here means it's better performance in its better performance is in phase A. So maybe that's why I had a better result when I used it in with a Vanguard. Support tab, I didn't use the MG because I felt its range is a bit low, 1000 meter. So instead I added a support gun, and I used of course the ISU 152. And I added some flamethrowers here as well. Anti-tanks. Well, I had two cards of the anti-tanks, but I also, since I am playing as a vanguard and I wanted to push, I used more SUs, 85. So I used two of them double vetted in phase A, and then I used this one in phase A as well. Anti-air, I tried to put as much anti-air as I can because the division has really poor air support. We'll see that now. In the artillery, as I said, I had one card of leaders and mortar as well, and one Katyusha, and then I added the off-map artillery. I didn't use long range range artillery because I didn't plan to for the division to last long, and it turns out that this division cannot perform well in phase B and phase C in particular. So I just wanted to add these units in order to win in phase A as fast as I can. The air tap, well, it has the Yak 1B and the Yak 9, but the problem with these is that they have really bad resilience. So they are very poor in front-to-front encounter, but they have good agility, which compensates this. So I added one card, and then I also used IL-2 as a bomber, and then I used a heavy bomber in phase B. So that was my configuration for the battle group, or let's call it a division, and that's it basically. So let's see how this division performed in a 1v1, and as I said, I played a couple of matches and I had bad luck against better players, especially imbalanced income. But then when I adjusted to Vanguard, I started getting a slightly better results. Let's see. So this is the game. I'm playing against a player called the Government. I don't know which government, but yeah. I'm playing, let's take this side. So I would say I am playing on the right side and he's playing on the left side. I am red and he's blue. So we started deploying our units. So let's see how this game went basically. This is one of the new maps which Eugene recently added. It looks similar to a map which we used to play in Steel Division 44, if I remember. So he's playing, my opponent is playing with the third armor, and as I said, I am playing with the second guard tank corps. So it's pretty balanced game. Both of us are playing with armored divisions. So I advanced here fast, trying to take this flag from him, using these Sapiris and flamethrower units. In this side also, I took this area, and this area is full of jungles and a city here, so it has lots of close combat. On the contrary, this area is a bit open, so I also advanced in this flank on the north side, trying to take the flag. In general, as I said, I had lots of defeat choosing this division, even against players who are below average. So my results were bitter, slightly bitter, when I tried to play as a vanguard. So that's when I was able to make a better results. Which makes sense since this division is designed to play in phase A, but I just think that this division could have been better, considering the fact that it is actually a sledgehammer to the Soviet troops in Operation Bagration. So I think it should have more fast units and better infantry. I know it's a tank division. It's not supposed to have good infantry, but I think this division would have been at least used some fast light armor. But let's see. So here he was able to push me back from the flag in the center. Of course, the American division, the 3rd Armored, has lots of M8s, which are pretty fast light vehicles. I deployed some SUs, 85 anti-tank destroyers, trying to destroy his tanks. He deployed lots of Shermans. In this side, on the north, I have completely control over this flag. And I have this support gun here hunting his M3 scout. Let's see if it's gonna destroy it. It has only 4 heat shields. It's basically doing nothing. Ah, it got it. It destroyed it. In the center, he's trying to push hard using his rifle squads supported by the Shermans. And I have deployed 2 anti-tank destroyers as well as T-34 85 command tank. I'm trying to suppress his infantry using mortars, and mortars here are a good strategy in the current game balance, because they fire fast, they have good rate of fire, and they tend to suppress infantry. He's overwhelming me in this position, supported by the tanks and mortar, as well as the rifleman. But he completely lost the city. He got one of the SUs. I think the position for the tanks here is not ideal, especially the tank destroyer. So I need to figure a way to put them here. Now he's trying to get my support gun on the north. That's fine. In the center, fight is going on. Heavy fight. The south is a bit calm. And I was able to destroy his Sherman, actually, here, I think by this gun. He's not trying to push in the south. Even he has a good chance to deploy some units here. His efforts is fully concentrated on the center. I got one of his tanks using the bazooka. destroyed my SU-85. This unit did a great job destroying two tanks already. T-34 against Sherman, who will win? The 57mm gun also was able to destroy the Sherman here. This unit, the Tanko, this Taniki, is very good in close combat. However, they are useless on medium and larger ranges because they only have like 100 meter range for their submachine gun. He destroyed my tank. Now he's trying to pushing his M8s to clear this area. I have large concentrated units here. And as a solution for his spam units here, I pushed one off-map artillery. I think I would have done better if I am playing another division. I feel this division lacks lots of essential things to fight, basically. I mean, it only has T-34s in tank section, and other than this, it's not really a good division. I think if against strong players, it would be a very difficult task, and that's what I experienced. I experienced myself. As I said, I had some defeats. So I'm pushing my Yak-9 here to destroy his recon plane. He immediately pushed B-51, which, oh, the Yak-9 was able to get the B-51. That is a bit strange for me, considering that I have a bad resilience. He's not having any anti-air here, which is not good for him. Finally, I am able to get this flag and trying to push some troops here. He's pushing another B-51, and maybe this time he will be able to destroy me. Yeah. The B-51 itself has also bad resilience, so it's no better than the Yak in front-to-front confrontation. He's pushing lots of riflemen, supported by M4 A1 76mm. I have full control over this area, and I'm trying to push in the south, in the center, and also I'm pushing on the north now. He's hammering me with mortars, and I am countering this by doing some off-map artillery. On the north, he was able to deploy an MG to suppress my troops from advancing. Right now I have 14 flag and he only have 10. That's why I pushed an aisle to, I think I'm gonna destroy his MG. Here there is a confrontation between the this 257mm and the Sherman. the Sherman wins. And the MG is gone. Here, let's see what the off map will do. Is it going to destroy some tanks or only suppress them? Nothing destroyed, but did a good job in suppressing the units in the middle. He's now trying to push light vehicle, the M3A1. Bullets. In the north, I'm trying to push further. I have a light tank here. In the center, most of the fight is going on. He's suppressing my infantry here. Now I pushed some tanks in this area, trying to push further. Here he's destroying any troops trying to pass because they have shorter range than his units. One of the bad things about this division also that troops with long range machine guns are not that good. I mean only this Gavardia. Their long range machine gun is not that good. So he's pushing me back in the center. I'm trying to push him on the north. That's why he responded by deploying this M4. He's now trying to get this IL-2. He's not well placed behind the plane. Here I pushed two tanks and now I started moving my units here. Advance. Same thing I'm doing here, but I don't realize that he has one rifle squad in this area. So I'm trying to launch full-scale attack on all fronts now. South, center, and north. He keeps hammering me with the mortar. I noticed that he doesn't have an anti-air, though. He's relying on the close fighter. And my T-34 takes over. Something can destroy. And I was able to suppress his infantry unit here, and I'm trying to push harder in the south. In the north, I'm not able to push because of this tank, that's why I'm advancing this anti-tank here. Now he started deploying some anti-air. This is pretty powerful anti-air, M16. He's gonna try to counter my heavy bomber now. Two B-51s. But he take them back fast because I have anti-air here. So taking these flags in the south have given me some advantage. I have now 15 flag and he has only 9. And I'm still trying to push in the center. And my anti-tank here was able to destroy his tank. So basically I have a better opportunity to advance now on the north as well. I have 14 flag and he only has 10 so far. Okay, so he's pushing one M4A1 76mm against two T-34s. Let's see if he's gonna be able to do something. He destroys the first T-34. He pull back his tank. I think he's gonna lose it because I am pushing one anti-tank squad against him. We have another force basically. And the T-34 bounces. And his tank is gone. He should have pulled that tank. On the south I have full control over the flags. On the north as well. I have 20 flag and he has only 3, so I think this is lost for him. Becoming overwhelming for him. Well, I think that against better players I would have been crushed basically. I don't like the division, to be honest, the way it's designed. I think it lacks lots of essential units. He had good kills though. Let's see my kills. Nothing out of ordinary. This T-34 destroyed lots of his units. Same as the light tank. I mean, for a division which is considered as a spearhead, it should have faster units. It should have better infantry units as well, maybe mechanized infantry, I'm not sure, but I feel somehow it's weaker than it should, the units that it has, but maybe I'm wrong, but that's just how I felt. My losses, he had a good kill with this Sherman. This Sherman as well. Sherman did really good job here. Also this Sherman. Most of his kills are with the Sherman, and that's normal because this is a tank division, third armored. Yeah, so this is basically was the review for this division. As I said, I feel that the division is a bit underperforming, especially with the new releases of the new divisions. They became more powerful than the old divisions which were released with the game. This is one of the first divisions released with the game. So I think more adjustment need to be done to this division to make it on the same at least performance with what is available currently on the game. Thanks everybody for watching, and I hope that you enjoyed this game.